Alright guys, so this is my buddy Festus, and he's stressed out. Look at that look on his face. He's like intensely stressed out right now because he can't remember his math formulas for his math class. So I'm going to show you and my friend Festus how to memorize math formulas, and hopefully this dude will chill out a little bit. Now, I'm going to turn this way. Okay. So the reason Festus has a hard time memorizing his math formulas, and the reason most people do, is they just seem nonsensical, or they seem like they're hard to memorize. And they are, but if you break them down into pictures, they're not. Let me show you what I mean. Let's take the volume formula for a sphere. The volume formula for a sphere is 4/3 pi r cubed. Let's take another one. The area formula for a parallelogram. And I'm just going to abbreviate it because this marker does misspell sometimes. So parallelogram, that's base times height. And area formula for a circular ring, that's 2 pi pw. So no matter what math formula you're trying to memorize, whether Festus is trying to memorize algebra or geometry formulas like this, or maybe you're a stockbroker and you need to memorize formulas, or you're any kind of student and you have formulas in physics or whatever. One thing that you're gonna find common to all math formulas is they're all gonna have variables in them that repeat. A variable is simply a letter, but normally, a variable is simply a letter for an unknown number. So here, R, which stands for radius, it's unknown. The B stands for base, A stands for height, P stands for perimeter, W stands for width. These are the variables, these are the unknown numbers. The first thing you need to do when you're memorizing math formulas is you need to take a look at all the formulas as a whole, and you need to see what the variables are. So right here we have R, we have B, we have H, we have P, and we have W. Then after you have your variables listed out like this, simply go back and create pictures for all these variables. For example, every R, I'm gonna say, is gonna be a rat. Every B is gonna be a bee, like a bumblebee. Every H is gonna be a hat, like a cowboy hat. Every P is a pirate. And every W is a window. So now we have our variables. So if you're looking at your math formulas, the first thing you do is you go through and you look at all the variables, and then you create pictures for the variables. R is a rat, B is a bee, H is a hat, for me, P it's a pirate, and W is a window. After you have your variables created, then it's simple. After that, it's really simple. You just go back and you make stories. Every math formula isn't a math formula anymore, it's a story, and stories are easy to remember. Okay, so let's take this formula first. A parallelogram, base times height. We already said that B is a bumblebee. This is my bumblebee outfit. And H is always a cowboy hat. So this is the picture that I want you to imagine. So for this one, we got for parallelogram equals base times height. Here's my bumblebee outfit. B, a bumblebee wearing a hat. BH. Imagine there's some parallel bars right here, some gymnastics parallel bars, and this bumblebee starts doing gymnastics on the parallel bars. God. I think I pulled a muscle. Okay, that's good enough. All right, the area formula for a circular ring is 2 pi pw. For p, we use a pirate. For w, we use a window. And for 2 pi's, we'll use 2 pi's. So imagine this. Imagine a pirate in a window, and he's wearing a circular ring, and he's eating 2 pi's. The area formula for a circular ring is 2 pi is 2 pi pw. It's as easy as that. Okay. So the next one is the volume formula for a sphere. Here's a sphere. The volume formula for a sphere is 4/3 pi r cubed. The way we remember this, sphere, and the equator is around the center. You have four continents on top and three on bottom. Some might overlap, but just for the purposes of this, let's say there's four on top and three on bottom. You have a sphere, four continents on top, three on bottom. On top of the globe, I want you to imagine a piece of pie, and it's getting eaten by a rat, but the rat is frozen because it's a North Pole. So, a sphere is 4/3 pi, R for rat, and he's frozen. Sphere equals 4/3 pi R cubed. So folks, that's how you memorize math formulas. The first thing that you do is you go through and you pick out all the variables, and you decide R is gonna be rat, B is gonna be a bumblebee, H is gonna be a hat, P is gonna be a pirate, and W is gonna be a window. And then, after you do that, after you have all the pictures for your variables done, you go through and create stories. Sphere is 4/3 pi r cubed. Parallelogram, the area formulette, is a b times h. Base is bh. Bumblebee and a hat is what we used. And then a circular ring, 2 pi pw. It's as simple as that. My buddy Festus is totally chilled out right now. He's got his math formulas down. He's going to ace his test. He still looks serious, but he's just a serious dude. I look forward to seeing you on the next video.